was just regular animal.
Okay. I think I know where I am.
Thank you.
man believed to be responsible for multiple stranglings in East Texas is finally in custody tonight. Authorities followed a tip that led them to a deserted motel outside Bryan, where they caught the man in the act of subduing 36-year-old Kelsey Keough. The man, whose name is being withheld, claimed he and Kelsey were participating in an agreed-upon way and that he had no connections to the murders that have plagued the eastern part of the state since last June. The search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. What should have been a night of memories and celebration turned into a scene one witness described as hell on earth. Teenagers at Dutton High School were celebrating an otherwise uneventful senior dance when two local men, identified as 43-year-old Packet Wayford and his 24-year-old son Grant Wayford, entered the gymnasium.
For. He'll help us. I know I can make him.
Come on back now. Let's just get this over with.
Come on! No! Just leave us alone!
Use that. For now.
I know they're still here.
Leave me alone. Come back. They're everywhere. painful.